We're all too familiar with the stories of businesses suffering, even shuttered, in the Great Recession. But one Wisconsin company is doing big business right now. Waterloo-based Trek Bicycle says it had its best month ever in April. UPFRONT made a trip to Trek to sit down with CEO John Burke and find out why the company is doing so well.
I think the economy is slowly recovering, and you know, here at Trek, we got a pretty good strategy. And you know, one of the things I always go back to is about 4 years ago we made a decision. It was 2006, and we weren't having our best year. And we always do really good at selling great products. And you take a look at what Apple has done, right? And they've just seen phenomenal growth. And I sat down with the head of our product group and I said, what would it take to make sure we have the best product in every single category? And he said, well, he said, we just need a lot more people. And I said, how many more people? I said, you come back to me with a plan. He came back the next week and he walked in. It was a plan to hire 50 people, which for us is a lot of people, right? Engineers, designers, product people. And at the end of the day, I think we ended up hiring like 80 people, right? And we created a world-class design center. We had a bunch of product people, a lot of R&D people. And so we have a seven-part strategy, and the first part is best-in-class products, period, all right? And we've just been churning out phenomenal products. And, you know, as technology has become more and more available to everybody, consumers figure out what the best products are, and that's the reason why we're doing as well as we're doing. It's product-based.
Take me back a couple of years ago, when the economy first showed signs that it was really struggling. Was that reflected here, or were you somehow able to be a bit more resilient and not feel the same impact?
You know, that's a great question. We did feel it here. I mean, we felt it here because we deal with a lot of small business people. A lot of small business people weren't getting bank loans. A lot of small business people cut their inventories. That affects us. A lot of people, we sell a lot of bikes, $3,000 and above. A lot of those people said, not this year. So really impacted our U.S. business. But one of the keys to our strategy is to become more of a global company. And at the same time, our U.S. business was feeling that economic pressure, our business in Europe and in Asia was just cranking. So, you know, you take a look at 2009, you know, we grew our business by a pretty decent margin, even though the U.S. business struggled.
So you were growing at a time where a lot of people were pulling back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you know, and that's simply because of product, and that's simply because, you know, we've said over the last 5 years, we have to become more of a global company, all right? We want to be the best bicycle company in the world. Well, 95% of the world is outside the United States. And so we've really focused a lot of our efforts on what can we do to grow our business outside of the U.S.
As a business person, are you concerned at all about what's happening globally? Since you are now doing business, I mean, you do business all around the world.
Yeah.
Are you concerned with what you're seeing?
Yeah. You know, the biggest thing that concerns me right now is the government debt. You know, you just saw what happened in Greece. You're seeing what's happening in Europe. You know, we've seen the slide of the euro in the last 2 months. You see that government debt in Greece and you see it in Portugal, and yet those are two relatively small economies. Similar type things exist in the UK, in Italy, and then you take a look at the government debt in the US and you go, well, what's going to happen? I haven't heard anyone give me a good answer on why I shouldn't be concerned about that.
John Burke, thanks so much for your time. We really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
You can see my entire interview with John Burke of Trek on our website. He'll explain why Trek wants to be the simple solution to complex problems in the world. Just click on the UPFRONT section of WISN.com. You'll also see more of my interview with Commerce Secretary Aaron Olver discussing specific tools the state has been using to promote economic development. Next on UPFRONT, another company doing big business, this one because of the Gulf oil leak.
UPFRONT is produced with editorial assistance from WizPolitics.com, an online public affairs news magazine and resource on public policy issues.